Happy New Year, everybody.
It's Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Laura. Hey. Happy New Year, Jeffrey.
I forgot to bring my vuvuzela.
Yeah, your what?
The horn thing.
I remember the horn thing.
Thank you.
Yes,
you
know, from the World Cup.
So welcome back.
We're already sidetracked.
Welcome back.
2017, going to be way better than the 16.
Welcome back to the show. My name is Larry Herbeck, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. As we just said, it's 2017. We're here with you. Laura's here.
Yes, I am.
Jeff is wearing his feathers. He's back from his Mummer's Day
parade.
From
the Mummer's Parade. There was some pretty
good
Mummer's. No.
Okay.
I didn't go when I lived there. I did go to the Mummer's Museum once, though. It's a weird thing.
We talk about this every year. It's the most bizarre thing because I remember going when I was a kid and Jeff and I, mm-hmm, you know, we grew up kind of near each other in Philadelphia. Yeah. No, we didn't. I was in the New Jersey side of the Schuylkill.
I couldn't afford to go there because the bridge, every year they would make
the bridge. Was that the Walt Whitman?
The Tacony Palmyra.
Okay.
Where occasionally the Betsy Ross, if we were rolling in it, because that cost $1 to cross.
That's right.
It's only a quarter for the...
crosses, that's the Philadelphia River, is that what it
is?
Delaware.
The Delaware River.
Which, of course.
Mm-hmm. It's a famous river.
Is it? Oh, that's Washington
crossed. So George Washington crossed.
Yeah, so if you ever seen that painting where, and I'll put it in the show notes, where he's very regally standing up on a boat, which I would
don't
not do, with the flag waving, that may not be an accurate representation. No. And then they went over and...
they were headed to the Mummer's Day Parade.
They went, yes, exactly.
So anyway, welcome back. It's great to have everybody here. We did a show before the holiday. We had great holiday. Was your holiday okay, Laura?
It was great.
You want to talk about it all?
I had a good break.
You had a good break? Okay.
Yeah, did lots of traveling.
Okay.
Saw family, did some relaxing. It was really good. It was one of those breaks where it felt like it was longer than it actually was, which never happens. I think I know the secret. I was in a different place almost every day. And that makes it seem really long.
Mm-hmm.
When you're in the same place, repetition.
I was
to go much faster.
Yeah, I understand that. I went back east. I did an event at the Microsoft store in Danbury.
Mm-hmm.
We had a few hundred people show up. Thank you if you showed up that evening and braved. Yeah, I don't know what I was thinking, Laura.
How cold was it?
It wasn't. It actually was colder here than it was there. But I don't know what I was thinking doing an event on the 23rd of December at a mall.
Yeah. Are you crazy?
I showed up and I'm looking around for parking, going, "Okay, I'm an idiot. I'm an absolute idiot." But anyway, it was a lot of fun. Everybody showed up and was out there. I stayed out with my sisters in New England, in Massachusetts, Rhode Island. Had a great time. So,
good.
Was it as cold there as it is here?
No, I just said.
Mm-hmm.
Did you not listen?
Not
no, I'm looking.
The
up
listeners
for the
even
best,
know.
I'm looking up for the best picture of Washington crossing the Delaware.
No, it was not as cold there as it was here, but now apparently it is. But we're back, Jeffrey. You want to talk about you were on holiday?
Yeah.
As they like to
as
say.
They say on annual leave.
On annual. Did I tell that story?
I don't think you have.
So the fun, I don't know if you know this story, Laura.
From Graham?
Graham, sorry, okay. Who we've had on the show.
Oh, yes.
He, you know, so he's a wonderful, love him. He works closely. We work on the same team. And whenever Jeff and I seem to send him an email, which is not frequently, but it's not infrequently, we always get what we call in Microsoft an OOF or an out of facility. That's why it's called OOF.
I was always wondering
out
why.
Out of facility.
The F was there.
Right. It's not out of office.
It's not like, oof, I just walked into a wall of you not being here.
So I just thought it was a horrible abbreviation.
No,
of out of office.
It is out of facility.
Okay.
And we get an out of office, but it's called out. We got a reply saying, hey, I'm on annual leave. And it feels like he's always on annual leave. And as... So we joked about it, and the funny thing was we were at, where were we? Where were we? Graham and I think it was maybe at E3, and we were talking to somebody, and some fans came up, and we were chatting with them.
Right.
And one of the fans says to Graham, yeah, I emailed you, but we got a note that said you weren't coming back until the end of the year. And it was just a perfect setup. So anyway, Graham is always on holidays. You know, the Europeans, they are not shy about being aggressive and taking all of every last ounce of their holiday the way they should.
Yeah, and you can't even send an email after 5 o'clock in France.
In France now,
that's right?
Yeah,
I saw that.
Yeah,
so great.
BRB
love that.
Moving to OOF, moving to France.
Okay.
Not mentioned there is text messages.
Right?
Yeah. Right?
Loophole.
Right? Yeah. So I know I've gotten text messages from people at the office.
As have I.
Including people here at this
well,
table.
We're different.
Yes.
It's more usually, are you playing Overwatch?
Well, although I must tell you this story, Laura, and you and I haven't chatted that much.
Mm-hmm.
So to your point of it felt longer than it should be, I'm like, okay, I'm going to go. I'm getting ready to get back to the office. So I wake up Monday morning, take a shower at 6 a.m.
You did that on Monday.
On Monday, I take my shower. I get in. I get all changed. I'm all out the door, and I get my coffee, and I'm on my way to the office. There's not a lot of traffic. So I text Jeff. Hey, Jeff, are you going to see at the office today? I should show you the text exchange because it was rather curt, wasn't it?
No.
He was like, nope. National holiday. Oh.
Oh, no.
Never mind.
Oh, no.
So we quickly, as we say in the business, repivoted and went to lunch. So we made a lunch date.
Yeah, I do this thing where when I'm on vacation, which I do not check email. So you got me nervous. I was like, maybe it is a
work day. I'm an idiot. Yeah. Yeah, so I started 2017. I didn't even tweet it. Unfortunately, I was only about a mile away from home.
Okay.
But I turned around. But it's now 7 o'clock in the morning.
Are you ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
You have a full day now.
Right. I can't. You can't go back to bed.
No, you can't.
So I've got my. So I went in and played like 3 hours of The Witcher.
Nice.
So
productive.
Productive. Anyway, so
Yeah. So I was in. I went to Iceland.
Iceland.
Oh.
Yeah. And then
how cold was it there?
It is well named. I will say that. There's ice, there's land. It was blizzarding like nonstop. Mm. It was pretty awesome. It's a great place. Super pricey. So I'm glad we're only there for about 3 days. And then we went on to London, which if you ever want London to feel cheap, you go to Iceland first. But the dollar is like super strong. So actually it was pretty good. Went to see my soccer team play Arsenal and sort of just hang out. Kind of wanted to be off the grid for a little bit. Mm-hmm. Like when you work in games, and you know this.
Mm-hmm.
It's really hard to take a vacation because we work on all of the games. So it's like when, you know, Gears shipped, it's like, well, that's not it for us. We're here for Dead Rising now. And it's like, we don't, you know, and I'm not complaining because we all love what we do. But the only time I know that I can take a vacation is typically after Thanksgiving.
Now, I'll tell you this. Something I learned a long time ago is a friend of mine who had been in the game industry for a long time, like older folks that have been in the game industry for a long time know the secret. Here's the secret. Do you want to tell you, Laura?
I don't know if I ever told you this.
I'm going to share it with all the listeners.
This will be a surprise to me.
What people that have worked in the game industry that work on individual games. Mm-hmm. So obviously you're working hard in the last few months before the game, you're trying to ship it. And when you ship it, it's like, hey, this is great. You know, but nowadays it used to be, okay, we're done. But now it's like you've got a patch that comes out. You've got downloadable content. You've got, you know, maybe the servers aren't, or there could be any number of things.
Right.
So what I've noticed is, and talked to a lot of my friends in the industry, what they do now is when the game ships, they have booked a cruise because they can't come back from a cruise. So, on a cruise, because you're on a boat. You know, it's not like you can fly back or you
can work, turn this thing around.
You can't change the schedule.
And you can't work remotely because you're on holiday, you're on a vacation
at
Disneyland. Right, but you're on the ocean. So the smarter, I don't want to say smarter, but those who have know the gig go on a cruise. So anyway.
Noted.
Yeah, noted.
That's my gaming secret of the year that I've learned over. Although I haven't been on that many.
No one takes less vacation than you, by the way.
Well, you know, this is the point of, you know, I enjoy my job. Mm-hmm. I love my job. I spent it, you know, when I go on quote unquote vacation or holiday, like when I was with my family back east.
You still work.
I go to the store.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Because I love going to, especially then, because I love going to see areas that we've never been to. We always go to LA. We always go to London. We always go to New York. We're doing events. I like to go, I'm down here. Let me go to the store. So I always contact the store and we try to spin up a neat event so I can go meet people that normally I would never get to meet. And I met the most amazing, amazing people when I was in Connecticut, just these people that didn't even know the store was there and they came in to see me. We had a great chat about what they were playing. And it was great. They not only that, but Laura, and you and I have talked about this a lot. These people, everyone listens to this show. And we have people that come up to us and remember, they ask how you are, Jeff. They ask how Laura is. They ask how E and Steptoe are. These are people that listen to the show for a long time. So to be able to meet with them and chat with them in a place we normally wouldn't be, that to me is really special.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, I love doing that.
We need to do that. I need to visit my grandma in South Florida.
We need to
go down together.
We need to do the Microsoft store in Miami.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll be up for that.
Although I do have a little bit of guidelines, which is I'm not going to Miami or to visit our store in Honolulu or San Diego unless it's like, you know, December, January, February. I am going to do this for slightly selfish reasons.
Do we have a store in Honolulu?
We do.
We do. It's really nice.
And they have been after me to do an event. And maybe, you know what, Honolulu? Maybe I need to come see you.
The Alamoana Mall.
Yeah. And apparently it's rather upscale and very nice.
Oh, well, the whole show should go.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I think that's a good idea.
We could stay at the Big Pink Hotel there right in Waikiki Beach, which I've stayed at.
Cool.
Which is...
I didn't know there was a Big Pink Hotel.
There is. And apparently the reason it's pink is it was painted during World War II. And that was only that was the only paint that was available because things were limited supply at that point. So they just painted it pink. Huh? I don't know if that's true. That's what somebody told me.
Let's just go with it.
That sounds good. So they certainly aren't going to paint it Battleship Gray.
Right.
That's nothing says fun resort like Battleship Gray. Anyway, let's jump into what we're playing, Laura. We'll start with you. And I want to talk about a great game that I found over the holiday.
Oh, you found a great game.
I did. Well, awesome. And Jeff knows what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So I haven't been doing, unfortunately, too much playing because I've been on the road and traveling.
See earlier conversation.
But I have been playing Dota a little bit here and there. But I think I've come to the end of my Dota playing.
You're like, okay,
so
did
I'm
it,
ready
done.
To move on.
Okay.
To my next thing. I'm looking forward to playing
how convenient.
Resident Evil 4 and other games that have come out recently.
And how convenient that that Diablo is getting a massive yes! update so that you can get time. Sucked back
yes!
into it.
I have not had a chance to check
did
out
you,
Diablo.
I tweeted that to you.
Did you see my response?
Yes, I did.
So I am looking forward to trying that out. I watched their video where they're explaining the anniversary.
Where they don't even say the name of it, New Tristram. They don't even say the name of it. I watched that whole video and they don't say the name.
Of the update?
Yes.
Oh, the anniversary update.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, they didn't.
It was weird. Yeah, I'm like, why isn't anyone saying the name?
So for those that have no idea what we're talking about,
yeah.
It's Diablo's 20th anniversary, if you can believe
it. Of the franchise.
Of the franchise. Diablo has been out for 20 years,
yep.
Which I can't believe. Maybe I'll refuse to believe it.
Laura, that is two-thirds of your age. A little more than two-thirds of your age.
Thank you. Thank you for reminding me. They wanted to celebrate in Diablo 3, and it started out with just wanting to change the music in Diablo 3, but it became a labor of love.
You can't do that.
It became a labor of love, and they ended up building the entirety of Diablo 1 in Diablo 3, and
right.
a dungeon of Diablo 3, the entirety of it, which is nuts, because that's a huge undertaking, and it was a labor of love.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm really looking forward to jumping in and seeing that labor of love, because there's nothing as amazing as when a game developer does it out of love.
Mm-hmm.
And great things come out of that.
I loved the first Diablo. I mean, they're all great.
So what level is your character?
I have a bunch of different characters at level 70.
Okay, because I know Ryan,
yeah.
our one of our video producers, he played it the other night, and he's got a couple of level 70s, so maybe you should roll with him,
because
you don't want to roll with me.
Though, apparently, the way they recommend you playing it is to roll a new character and to play Diablo 1 with a level 1 character and get the full experience as if you're
Why,
really
thank you
Diablo
for inviting
1.
Me, Laura. So, I'd love to join you.
So, it's open to everyone of all levels and experiences. Though I hear Diablo 1 it's similarly hard as it originally was. They changed it back to the typical type of
So you're looking forward to that.
Bosses. Yeah, I'm looking forward to jumping in and seeing how it goes.
So that's what you're playing.
I will play that.
We will play that.
Probably this weekend.
I played, of course, we played Overwatch. It was the holiday Overwatch. It was delightful, Jeffrey.
Oh, I love it when the new kids come in, though.
Yeah, that's
true.
You missed your loot boxes.
Oh, that's so true. The holiday influx
of
new players.
When you go 27-1 with D.Va in your first match in a month, you know there's new people
Merry Christmas.
Yes. the greatest gift I received.
So I played that. We talked about the lure. I got back into The Witcher. I never
yes.
finished it.
Yes.
And I just, for some reason, I saw it. It was pinned in my pins and I booted it up. And 5 hours later, I'm still playing it. So now, Jeff, you finished it.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm not even in Act 3 based on what I understand. I just get so sidetracked.
There's a lot to do. The one thing I will say, like what you start to feel like you're going towards the end game, but the end game
of
The Witcher is longer than most games.
Right.
But it's all really good, really impactful.
Oh, it's excellent.
I will say this.
Yes.
Because at some point I was like, you know what? I want to just finish this game. I'm not doing any more side missions. I'm just plowing through towards the end. There will be someone, a character will come to you when you feel like you're just about to wrap it up with another side mission, take that side mission.
Noted.
It does have a impact on the... I was just like, yeah, I'll come back to you later, buddy. I'm about to go, you know, slay Bowser. And and then I severely regretted it.
Okay, noted. Well, anyway, so I'm playing that, of course, Overwatch. The game that I found, Laura, is... And you since you were traveling, you probably didn't see this chatter. Jeff and I and E were talking about was Mini Metro.
I was just going to talk about that.
Haven't heard of it.
So Mini Metro is a game for your phones and your iPads. And essentially what it is, Jeff, you have it there, right?
Yep.
How would you describe it, Jeff?
So if you've ever looked at like a subway map in New York or London or something like that, imagine if you were the urban planner and you drew that on the map. So it's shaped like this and it's like, okay, there's like new stops pop up and you have different lines and then you can connect them like, oh, how are we going to get to there? And so you see where people want to go and it's very simple.
And the people get on the right trains. You just need to make sure that the lines are properly.
Right.
Yeah, that they
stretching.
Can get there.
Brilliant.
And then after every week, depending on how well you get to add another train car so it has bigger capacity.
Another line.
Or another tunnel because they all have rivers or something. So there's something that limits you. You can't endlessly go back and forth across rivers. Anyway.
And the music is procedural. So it's very soothing. It's interesting because you get stressed out, but it's soothing.
Yeah.
But I'm serious. I bought it because you and I and Jeff were chatting about it on Twitter. And I was like, let me check this out. And I was like, oh my God. It was like 6 hours later. I was playing it like all night. It was just, I got my sister into it.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
And they're based on real cities. So, with New York, I was like, okay, I more or less know what the New York subway system looks like, or at least the main lines that go north and south and where it goes over to Queens and Brooklyn. Mm-hmm. And so I was trying to do that. Mm-hmm. But the game doesn't always, you know, cooperate. Like the demand might be different. And mm-hmm. so I was like, you see like how like the logic came together for I kind of like subways, like how it came together and like how difficult it must have been to here you can just reroute
proper,
it real quickly.
Yeah. Civil city planning.
Yeah.
It reminds me a bit of Bridge Constructor, would you say?
No.
Like where you're doing...
It's more like Sim City, but only with trains. Okay. And I mean, I guess it's very basic and very simple, but there's a lot of depth to it.
I'll fire it up on my phone if you want to play it later. Yes. But I'm serious. It's a lot of fun. So speaking of subways, do you know a new subway opened in New York? The first one since 1920?
What?
Oh, the Second Avenue.
Yeah, the Second Avenue. You're right. Yeah. Well done, Jeffrey. Huh?
Finally, I know my public transit.
Three stops finally opened up over there on the east side. So it's anyway, I don't know why. Because we're talking about subways. And you talked about New York.
Well, we're going to be getting one here in Seattle in like 2037. Mm-hmm. You know, hopefully one day I won't have to take the bus. I'll be able to take a train.
Good for you.
One day. Yeah, Larry's like, nah.
I like my electric car. So yeah.
Well, you're part of the solution, Larry.
I am. Well, I'm trying to be. So anyway, so that's all. Yeah. So Mini Metro, Laura. Can we put a link to that, Jeffrey?
Oh, yeah, can do.
Because I think it's something that you would enjoy, and I think it's on multiple platforms. So we need to get that on Windows.
Yeah.
The bigger screen, the better.
Okay.
I find when you play it on the small screen, at least look. I got big fat hands.
It's on Steam, so there's a number of ways you can play.
Yeah. So, but I found that it works better for touch.
Well, I have a touchscreen Surface.
Like, that
should work great.
What?
Okay. Just go ahead and do that.
Good point. So, anyway, that's what I'm playing. Jeffrey, what are you playing?
Yeah. So while I was traveling,
by the way, Bridge. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry to cut you off.
No,
I get yelled at for all this time. I did play some of the new Bridge Constructor.
You did.
Yeah. So it's hard. So I just because you mentioned that earlier. I'm sorry.
I couldn't even finish the first one.
Oh, how hard is it compared to the first one?
It's significantly harder because you have to do a lot more.
Do they at least teach you about bridges in Bridge Constructor?
I don't think they did this time.
Okay. Because that's my one piece of advice for Bridge Constructor is make it be a bit more educational. Like, this is a suspension bridge.
Right.
This is a...
And here's why it's strong. It's because of these things. Because we talked about triangles, remember? Mm-hmm, originally.
Mm-hmm. So they did teach you about triangles, but then that's the only teaching they did.
So, no.
But I love learning about bridges and play a game at the same time.
Speaking of that, you know what and I'm sorry, Jeff, I know I interrupted you, but you know something we played all over the holiday with my family was Jackbox Party Pack.
Really?
That was the best.
Because, you know, you can play with your devices. We had people on laptops and tablets and PCs and Macs and iPhones and Androids and Windows. We had all these devices going. We were just having the greatest time.
Like Drawful?
We did Drawful. My sister, who is, she always, you know, she looks at me sideways when we talk video games because I'm her brother. She was totally, so can we play it again? Sure, we can play it again. So we played it for hours. Highly recommended if your family, you know, that way you don't have to, it just works with any device. It just works great.
Yeah.
There you go. Laura's Mini Metro.
We're up to like volume 3 now, I want to say, on Xbox.
Yeah. And here's a pro tip. We played with some kids. There is a family friendly filter you can turn
on. That's great.
In the options.
And it's generally pretty, it's not, you know.
Well, there is one. There is one there that was like it was
Cards Against Humanity S.
No, it wasn't that bad. But we had to explain what happens when a male or female human gets excited.
Got it.
So it was very strange. All right, now Jeffrey.
On that note, so while I was traveling, I was testing out a new Razer laptop because there's a lot of games that I haven't finished. So I spent a lot of time when I had downtime. Playing Dead Rising 4 on Windows 10, and that's a great game. I love that there's constant sort of progression. You're always unlocking new abilities, and the game is just sort of like a slot machine, and every time you pull the handle, like something good comes out. So like every time you play for 10 minutes,
like a gumball machine,
I suppose.
Because slot machines, sometimes you lose.
Yeah, but it's just like a slot machine you always win on.
Oh, I see.
Yes. Whereas gumballs will just give you cavities. They're never sugarless.
They even have gumball machines anymore?
They like at Walmart. I feel like they always have like a bank of them. Yeah, and the little
places.
Eggs.
Of all the places I'm gonna have a gumball, Walmart is the absolute dead last.
It's the only reason I go to Walmart. Okay. I love to get the gumballs. Okay. So Yeah, because there was like 21 hours of night in Iceland. It was like super dark.
Oh my goodness, that's yeah, so true.
It was really hard to get out of bed. The sun would rise around 10:30 or 11.
Oh my goodness.
So I was like, every time I got home, I was like, yeah, I'm going to fire up Dead Rising. Also, then when I got back, I'd been saving this, and it's Final Fantasy 15. And I've played, I'd say most of the Final Fantasies over the last like 15 years. This is the best one since 10. I'm 10 hours in. It's really, really good. The production values are just like stratospherically high. But
yeah, I started playing, I think I'm 2 hours in.
It's, I like the combat is both strategic and action based. So there's just like a lot there. And I kind of love that it's the first Final Fantasy I can think of that's not, with the exception of like the beginning of 7, that is in like a less fantastical, more of like a real world scenario. Like you have a car and you're like driving
crazy
around
with the suicide doors.
Yeah. It looks like a super expensive Bentley or something. Right.
Well, you know,
that.
People want to have that in Forza. They're asking for that car in Forza.
We need to have that
in
Forza.
I know.
That would be amazing.
So
we have the Warthog, which is like the best car in Forza Horizon 3, by the way. So it's, the design of the characters, which looks like a boy band, like at first I was like, it's not for me. They quickly grow on you. And
nobody's really an expert on boy bands than Jeffrey from Central Florida.
It's true. I did see Joey Fatone once at a restaurant in downtown Orlando.
Really?
Yeah.
Good for you. Was he waiting tables?
Ouch. He did not pick up the tab. So, I guess I am the expert. So it was, Final Fantasy 15. If 13 like wasn't really your jam, this may be the one that brings you back. I'll put it that way. So that's pretty awesome. And then I guess while I was, besides Mini Metro, when I was on the flight, played a lot of Pokemon Moon, which is also really good. I hadn't really gotten into a Pokemon, like a full mainline Pokemon game, and since like Silver or Pearl, and Diamond or Pearl, I think. Like, obviously a long time. This one's really good. Like a lot of the annoyances or whatever, it does a lot of like user-friendly things for an RPG. So I guess I'll credit E. He obviously must have contributed in some way.
I'm sure.
It's definitely the best Pokemon game in many years.
Oh, maybe I should check it out.
You're just looking at me. It's like an RPG, Larry.
No, I know. Yes. I'm
collecting RPGs.
You gotta catch. Oh, okay.
No.
Just, dear listener, it's very good. If you ever liked a Pokemon game,
so I just want to point out, while in between when I started talking about what I'm playing and what you're playing, Laura has downloaded and has started playing Subway Lines.
Yeah. Playing Mini Metro.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Added a locomotive to one of my lines.
Good.
Hey, there's. People are missing out. They're waiting.
You have your device muted, but the music's actually part of the fun.
Okay.
I've only ever played it on mute, so I'll have to start.
No, it is. It's just, it's soothing. It's relaxing. Mm. It's kind of.
Does it make like little whistle stop noises?
It doesn't do that.
Well, maybe they'll update it. They're listening right now. Mini Metro people.
Mm-hmm. Mini Metro. All right. So we're kind of, it's kind of a weird time because it's after the holiday. Releases are kind of quiet. Consumer Electronics Show is on this week, Laura. I'm not down there.
Yes.
You've never been.
I've never been to CES.
I've been a few times. Jeff, you've been too.
5 times?
Yeah, I think that's as many times
I've
been.
Like Comic-Con, like one is the sweet spot. You should see it once. You shouldn't have to go every year.
Is it always in Las Vegas?
Yes, it is. Yeah, it's massive.
I will say this year, it seems like the rebirth of the gaming laptop
and
the gaming PC.
Yeah.
Like a lot of companies that previously didn't have gaming laptop lines, like
into it.
Samsung,
Lenovo. Yeah.
And there is some really, really cool hardware. And ever since like the 1080 line, the Pascal chips came out from Nvidia, the prices have gone down significantly. I mean, there was a time when you had to pay like that laptop tax, and it wasn't even that long ago, where to get something that could play something like Gears 4 or something like that would cost thousands more than the desktop equivalent. And now it's significantly more affordable.
Now,
so,
have you seen the Razer announcement?
Oh my God. Mm-hmm. The Project Valerie.
Have you seen this?
No.
So this is a laptop.
The three screens.
The screens, yes.
I didn't see that.
Yeah.
I didn't know it was called the Project Valerie.
Whatever
but
it is. Apparently it weighs 12 pounds.
Yes. Wow.
I'll put a link to this thing is amazing. I just love that it exists.
Portable. computing.
And did you see the 21-inch curved laptop? Yeah. I think it was from, it might be HP.
Yeah.
This thing is ridiculous.
So there's a lot of laptops.
I'll link to the craziest ones in the show.
Well, yeah, I think the Windows blog has a bunch of the stuff up there, right, Jeff?
Why, yes. Why, yes, they
doesn't
do.
It? Yeah, so yes. We should put a link off to that. So sure. Anyway, so yeah, CES is this week. Haven't been in a long time. It's a show you need.
Could you imagine using that laptop with three screens on a plane?
No, you'd actually have to buy the seats in the middle and buy the seats on either side of you.
Sit in the middle. Yeah. And hope and cross your fingers the person in front of you does not lean his seat back.
You'd have to board with a 2x4 and lay it across the row, and that would support it because it would probably break the seat table, the tray.
Crazy stuff, crazy stuff, I'll tell you.
I love it.
So yeah, so we got CES this week. We got a little bit of news, right, Jeffrey? Let's go over to the news desk.
Hey. So I would say it's a little bit slow on the news front. There's a lot of, I think, there's a lot of games that are now available for pre-order in the last week. So things are sort of like getting ready. So Styx, Shards of Darkness, Rise and Shine, Metrico Plus. This is another game that I feel like, since I liked Mini Metro, it seems to be based on like graphing and stuff. It's sort of like a platform-ish type of thing. Doodle God, Ultimate Edition, 8 Days, Kill the Bad Guy. All these games are now available for pre-order. The best place to find... just basically a list of those would be on majornelson.com, yes. As it were.
Yes.
It's a pretty good site. You should check it out there, Larry.
I try to do what I can do.
Yeah. Other than that, really just looking forward to, towards the end of the month, Resident Evil 7.
Very good. But
this is a good time to catch up on those other games.
It is. Yes. Hopefully you got a stack of games under your Christmas tree or... do you put them under the menorah?
We had to come up with a... did I tell you about the Hanukkah hawk?
No.
All right. Well, obviously this is something that doesn't exist in any real life scenario.
Hold on a minute. Should we tell the younger listeners to tune out or?
I don't want to ruin the thing that I made up.
Some illusion.
So, usually in most years we have a Christmas tree. We did not have a Christmas tree this year because we were traveling the whole time. Last year, we celebrate both Hanukkah and Christmas. It's sort of the highlights. We have a Christmas tree. We have hot cocoa. We have stockings up and we light a menorah.
Awesome.
That's about as far as it goes. But last year, I have a 7-year-old. So last year she was 6 and we had sort of like a currency in the house. Mm-hmm. She's a little spoiled. And so I wanted to make sure that she had to earn her toys.
Mm-hmm.
And she wanted this Lego set. She's huge into Legos and has been for a while. And she wanted a really nice one. And so we had, every time she was good, she would earn a couple of marbles. And if she was bad, I would make a big show of taking one away. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And man, did that work. she was a little bit short and we had bought it for her. And it was the first night of Hanukkah, mm-hmm. Which was a little early last year. And so she had... We made a big show of her earning just enough. And I was I hadn't really thought through how the marbles would then turn into how she gets the present, which we had already bought.
Mm-hmm.
And so I made up that I was going to go make an offering of the marbles to the Hanukkah hawk, mm-hmm. which in my mind was something out of Lord of the Rings, mm-hmm. and who would then take the marbles and drop off the Legos.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, it's the most absurd thing possible. And somehow she bought into it.
Mm-hmm.
And so now the Hanukkah hawk brings her Legos every year on Hanukkah, apparently. But this actually reminds me, this is an amazing thing.
Reminds you of what?
So while we were in Iceland, they don't do Santa Claus. Because mm-hmm. she was wondering, how is Santa going to find me? And I did not have an answer to that. But then we found out all about the Yule Lads. So they do not have Santa Claus in Iceland, but they have the Yule Lads, which is 12 or 13 elves who... basically cause mischief. So their names are stuff like Spoon Licker, Door Slammer, Window Peeper. There's one that every day.
Bedwetter?
there's one that every day one of them comes into town and causes mischief. Mm-hmm. But and if you're good, they'll leave you a present. Oh, you're supposed to leave your shoe
mm-hmm.
on the windowsill. If you're good, they'll drop a present in your shoe. If you're bad, they will put a potato in it. And
well, that's more useful than coal.
You can actually, but if you're bad for a week, you can make your own French fries. So what we did is we ended up putting a shoe out for it. Like, they're everywhere, like, throughout Reykjavik. Like, they have projections onto walls, like holograms, mm-hmm. like one of each of the Yule lads.
Yeah. So how many are there?
12 or 13. I'll link. It's kind of interesting and kind of weird. They're all kind of, like, creepy. Like, one of them just sort of hangs out and is awkward.
Not as creepy as Krampus.
I feel like, no, they're not as overtly frightening as Krampus, right. But they're all kind of, like, unwanted guests, I feel like, in a way. One of them steals the ham out of your sandwich with a fishing line. I'm like, you cannot make this stuff up. So,
that's amazing. I've never heard of the Yule Lads.
But, like, they're everywhere. And so, like, I, like, went to, like, the equivalent of a 7-Eleven, and, like, mm-hmm. I was handed a magnet, and it was, like, the calendar, and it was, like, which Yule Lad was going to show up on which day. Oh, and apparently, if you're badly dressed, then a giant cat will kill you. So you have to buy new clothes for Christmas. This Iceland's pretty awesome. Like, I was totally on board with this. Anyway, we had her put her shoes out, and I got her a Kinder Egg, and then I put a potato in the other one because she's not that good.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Got a potato. All right, then.
She was very excited to get that potato, let me just tell you, because it meant the Yule Lads were real.
So we learned about the Hanukkah hawk and the macaw menorah.
Yes, yes. But the Yule Lads I will link to because it's kind of amazing.
Well, hopefully, listeners, you got games in your shoe for the holiday.
Yeah.
You can then, play.
So here's what I want, dear listeners, because you're a creative lot. Send us an email, Laura or myself, major@xbox.com or lollipop@xbox, and let us know what should be the 13th Yule Lad that's based around games.
All right, here. There's pot
is scraper. Is it the game liquor. Spoiler?
It's the hot dog spoiler. One, by the way, is sausage swiper.
Hey-o.
Window peeper, doorway sniffer, meat hook, candle stealer. I'm linking to Yule
Lads. Wait a minute. How has no one done a video game with all these characters?
How has no one done a video game?
That's
an amazing amount of creativity.
So, anyway, let's put a link to that there. But I'd love for people to know we should have one based around video games.
Yes.
Right? Is it Disc Stealer, Disc Scratcher?
Disc Scratcher.
Right?
Or Internet Cutter.
Internet
Cartridge Blower.
Internet Capper.
Yes.
Oh, don't get me started.
He uses up all your
Don't
all
get
your
me
bed.
Started on that, people. You've seen me kvetch about that, haven't
Password
you?
Password changer.
Yeah. Oh, boy. Yeah, we need Yule Lads for the digital age.
Profile picture switcher.
Right. Password resetter.
Yeah.
We can just go on and on. This is delightful. And this is why you download this show, dear listeners, isn't it?
Just to hear about imaginary Yule Lads.
All
there
right.
There should be something with someone that trips the circuit breaker.
Yes.
Right before you save.
That sounds like a Batman arch villain circuit breaker.
Yeah. Maybe it'll just be
You realize that tripper. there's some desperate screenwriters in Hollywood right now just siphoning off all of this
activity. Gold, Larry, gold.
This is gold. I'm telling you, Jeffrey, it's gold. All right, we're going to move along to some of the news headlines, which we started to go to the news desk, but then we got distracted.
There's no news, Larry.
There really isn't.
There's nothing.
There really isn't, is there?
Oh, well, I guess I would say this, if you had been away from your Xbox for a little bit and you forgot, don't forget, Comeback Games with Gold are waiting for you right now.
Mm-hmm.
Van Helsing, or one of the Van Helsing games, a new one, actually debuted as a game with gold that's available right now. World of Van Helsing Death Trap.
Yes.
And I don't have the Xbox One handy. Wait.
It's on my blog, majornelson.com, at the very top.
Or the Xbox 360.
Games with Gold link.
That's right at the top.
Right.
That's good. When did you put that?
That's what we do here. We put the information where people want it.
Wow. I wish I had known about that. The Cave. Oh, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, the talking one.
Yes.
From Ron. Yeah,
Ron.
I interviewed him. I have a show. I think I have an interview about The Cave. I should pick that up.
He has another game coming out this year, too.
Does he?
I feel like. Yeah.
I got to find out where that show is. Put a note in there that I want to link to The Cave interview, because that would actually probably be a good one to interview, too, to link off to. I didn't remember doing that one.
Yes.
Yes.
All right. What part of the show are we at?
I don't know. What part of the show are we at? We're unfortunately, we are in uncharted territory right now.
Podcast Stumper has come into the studio.
Exactly. I guess should we
name the game?
You know, we should do name the game. And I think people have figured out that when we recorded the last show, we knew we were going to be on holiday.
Yes, for a couple of weeks.
Apparently, some people were embracing holiday a little bit more than others, Laura. Mm-hmm. And it was extra difficult.
Uh-huh.
It was extra difficult. Mm-hmm. So why don't you ready to play it?
Let's roll the name the game from last time. So again, that was Name the Game from last time. And as Larry mentioned, it was a hard one.
It was a tough one.
It was a tough one. But there was one person,
yep,
probably a few more than just one, that actually got it right. And it was, the game was Don Bradman Cricket 17.
Yay.
I don't know what cricket sounds like. Does it sound like baseball?
It does. There was, mm-hmm, I believe there was a crack of the bat. Mm-hmm.
And then, this one's out of there.
Exactly. So.
Back, way back.
Yeah. So that was a...
That's really good.
That's really awful.
All right. Thank you. From the pool of winners, we chose a random one.
Yes.
And the winner this week is Scott from South Australia.
And they know their cricket down there. So congratulations. I was recently in South Australia.
You were.
Well, I don't know if
we're doing an amazing talk.
I don't know
talk.
Where. You're so kind, Laura. Thank you.
It was good.
Did we link to that last show?
We did.
Okay, good. Okay. So this was a hard one, cricket. Yep. But
congratulations, Scott.
But it was worth it, right, Scott?
It is. Hopefully, Scott, you will receive a huge, awesome bag of prizes. Up first, we have a copy of Astroneer.
Yay.
Then after that, Shantae Half Genie Hero.
Mm-hmm.
A copy of The Walking Dead, A New Frontier.
Mm-hmm.
The complete season.
Yes.
Assassin's Creed, The Eero Collection.
Yes.
Watch Dogs 2.
Yes.
And that's not all.
That's not all.
Gears of War 4 Ultimate Edition.
so many games.
Scott from South Australia, you have a ton of games to go check out and try.
I also want to point out that Scott also has a lot of great karma coming his way, Laura.
He does?
Yes. I was reading in his email, and I think he's okay if we share this.
Okay.
He takes in rescue cats.
Oh, and that's great.
Two-thirds of us in this show love animals. That would be you and I, Laura. Sideways glance at Jeff.
Evil stare back from Jeff.
Just because I don't invite them into my house.
You love animals. I
love that other people love animals.
Right.
Save the rainforest. That's great.
Yep.
I just don't want to go there.
Yeah. I understand.
Yeah.
All right.
Anyway, thank you for that.
Well, congratulations, Scott from South Australia.
Congratulations, Scott. Now, you have probably heard all those great prizes that Laura stole out of my office to give away, which is fine. This is why I have those things in that
mm-hmm.
pile.
Mm-hmm.
But that means we're ready for a brand new Name the Game. The first one of 2017.
So excited. The first Name the Game of 2017. Let's roll the tape. So that was the first Name the Game for 2017. If you too would like to win fabulous prizes, it's super easy. All you have to do is listen to the sound effects.
Mm-hmm.
Send me an email, lollipop@xbox.com and ccmajor@xbox.com, and just let us know what game that is.
Yeah.
It's super easy.
Yeah. Why aren't you doing it already?
Exactly. Just send us an email.
Why aren't you doing it, Laura? No, not you.
Not me.
Not you.
I'm not eligible to win.
So we've got...
But anybody who's listening...
Anybody who's listening...
Microsoft employee
yep.
can win.
Yep.
Fabulous prize.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to add on to that. You can't be a Microsoft employee or, and I'm looking at you, Step Tony, former co-hosts on the show. So anyway, there you go.
Great.
Yep.
So that's Name the Game. Good luck to all our listeners.
Brings us kind of towards the end of the show. We usually talk about cool stuff. Did you get any presents for the holiday? Was Christmas a big deal for you, Laura?
I did. Santa brought me a new gaming mouse for my PC. I got a Razer Mamba.
Yeah, I have one of those.
Those are really nice.
It lights up on the side.
It lights up and it's got great DPI.
Did you like customize it?
No.
It's got like pulsating and ripple.
I changed the colors.
To what colors?
A purple, kind of like the shirt that you're wearing.
Oh, okay.
Right. Yeah. And you can change it based on the game that you're playing.
Yeah.
It's very, very customizable.
Yeah,
it's very sophisticated.
Yeah.
But I haven't gotten into all the finer details of the settings in there. But
yeah.
I was able to adjust the DPI, and it's amazing.
Yeah.
The button action on that is fantastic.
Clicky, clicky, clicky.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it feels good.
Feels
good.
Feels really good.
I don't know if I have anything to share. I don't think... I think I'm kind of dry right now.
Oh.
It was just a busy holiday.
No new gadgets?
No, I was busy traveling and buying stuff for my sisters mm-hmm. and my mom. I was helping my mom out with her stuff. You know, it's always great when you go home for your family and you're the tech support guy,
mm-hmm.
you know, so.
My grandmother does that and she keeps a list.
Yeah,
she
my mom does
it down,
too.
and says, hey, Laura, so, can you help me with my list?
I got to tell you this funny one. I love my mother, but I'm going to share this little funny story. So we get, she has the same exact list. So I go to her house and we're sitting down. I say, okay, mom, what do we got today? So she's okay. She pulls out her little, she has a steno pad. She loves steno pads. So do you know what a steno pad is? Okay. She opens up her steno pad and she's right. She says, okay. And it's all, in all different pens, because obviously she wrote it over the series of months when I haven't seen her last. And we go through, we're working on this, working on that. And then one of the items, like fourth one down, is like Facebook ads. I'm like,
what does that mean?
Yeah. I said, mom, what's going on here? She says, well, I don't like it when I search for things and then I go to Facebook and then there's things that I searched for in the ads.
Yes.
About
said,
that.
I said, I said, well, mom, that's kind of their business model. She says, I know, but I don't like it.
I don't like it either.
So I, you know, I showed her kind of how to solve that problem. So anyway, it was just this funny thing. And she was very crisp and clear exactly what she didn't like. She said, I don't like going to Facebook and seeing those ads of things that I searched for recently.
That's great.
Okay, mom. So anyway, so I tried to help her with that.
That's
so
great. Well, but yeah, no, it was being the helpful son. Yeah, okay, tech support son.
There was not a lot of time that I had to go out and catch out new stuff. I mean, I've got a few things, still working on some networking gear. You know, I have my Eero's at home, which I love, and you know, my home networking stuff. But the other thing is just the irritation of my Comcast data cap, which I was tweeting about. Did you see how close I got? Did you see how close I got?
You're on the razor's edge, Larry. You're playing a dangerous game.
Yeah, so I tell you, it's like playing the price, a crazy version of the Price is Right. You know, get as close as you can without going over. But it was pretty darn close. But yeah, I just haven't had a chance to do that. I'm getting a bunch of new gear for the next next few months that I'll be working on. So we're now, I think I tweeted it out earlier in the week, 154 days away from E3, Jeffrey.
No, the countdown started already.
Oh, not only countdown, Laura, but we've had multiple emails and email conversations on this over the holiday. So we've made some decisions and we're doing some cool stuff. So
important meetings.
Yeah, a lot of important meetings. So Jeff and I are heavily involved with that. And Lori, we need to have you back down again.
That'd be great.
Wait, did a story just get written?
Yeah, you can hear someone madly typing away on that. There,
it is a slow news week.
That's why whenever we say anything, they pick apart this show, Lori, don't they? So anyway, whatever you guys
look for the expose on the Yule Lads. There's going to be a movie next Christmas here.
The Yule Lads.
Yeah,
we should write up a film treatment for that screenplay. The Yule Lads.
Yeah. Which one will you play?
Well, wait a minute. There's 12 of them.
Yeah. Plus the cat. Plus there's like a witch.
We just need to do an episode for each one.
The 12 Yule Lads of
right
spring.
Welcome to Pot Scraper.
It could be like the, you know, there's 18 or 20 James Bond films. It could be, you know, this, it could be a 30-year franchise, the Yule Lads.
Yeah. I kind of like that.
I don't know. There's something there.
There's definitely something there.
Are they licensed? Or are they just...
I don't know. I think it's just more of a property of Iceland.
I love how actually considering this you are.
It's right to be picked, isn't it, Laura?
It would make for an amazing game. There's some crazy characters that I would love to understand.
You
got to
dodge the cat that will kill you if you don't have new clothes.
Right. I need to figure this out. I need to work this up in a treatment. I need to get my screenplay buddies on the line. I've got a movie here. A superhero. And what's the superhero? Is there, now are these bad? Are they good?
No, I think we need to empower like some children. Like out of like Spy Kids or Home Alone or something like that.
Stranger and they have to, style.
They're dodging the cat. The cat is the monster from the Upside Down.
Yes.
And then the Yule Lads, I feel like they're like Tom Bombadil. They're neither good nor evil. They're just a force of nature. But maybe they band together.
Yeah. We all have a screenplay inside of us.
This is good.
Let's meet up after this.
Yeah.
They're like the Ents. You have to win them over.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yeah.
They just are. They just are.
They just are, and you have to win them.
Yeah.
All right. You know what we're gonna do? We're gonna go work on this idea. We're gonna let everybody wrap up there. Wanna thank everybody for coming in, Laura. I wanna thank you. Welcome back. Welcome to 2017.
Welcome to you as well.
I hope 2017 is gonna be better than 2016. Man, we lost a lot of celebrities and notable people, and that whole we didn't even talk about, by the way, we didn't even talk about Star Wars.
Yeah, that's true. Right, we still have to do our spoiler cast.
Yeah, because we've all seen it. Maybe we should do a little. Do we have a few minutes? Maybe we do it after. I don't know.
We do.
But you know the whole Carrie Fisher thing—a terrible story. Yeah, now I don't know. Someone told me. I read this tweet. There's a I don't want to say it's more of a biography of she and her mom that's coming out later this year, posthumously.
Oh, really?
Yeah, really disturbing. Anyway,
what I didn't know about Carrie Fisher is that she has done like a ton of like script work. She's punched up scripts and a lot of things that I think that we know that have nothing to do with Star Wars that she's had a hand in.
Right.
She, you know, very funny.
I also didn't know that she had a special on HBO. Did you know that?
Yes, that I knew.
I hadn't seen it. And so it's on my list of things to watch. I saw a few clips of people who had edited it and put it up on social media of different important moments in her life, but it's very interesting.
Yeah. There was just so much. I guess one of the biggest losses, I mean, there's a lot of losses, unfortunately, in 2016. Yeah. The creator of the Red Solo Cup died.
I saw that.
Frat boys everywhere are sad.
So the Red Solo Cup is more than it appears.
Oh, Jeffrey. This?
So it's not just a straight up and down cup. There's a lot of different ridges and lines.
Those, a good place for those your things, hands.
Well, no, those lines mean something. And so you can actually mix a drink by looking at the lines. Like a certain one, like the first ridge is like half a shot. And then as it goes up, the second ridge is like, an American pint. And the second one is like an English pint or whatever. The lines actually, there's something diagramming what each line on that solo cup means.
The secret language of the solo cup.
Mm-hmm. I am. All right.
You're going to link to that too.
It's kind of amazing.
That there's a country song about the Red Solo Cup?
Yes, there is.
And we can use that to end the show.
I don't know if I'm licensed to use it, Laura. I would love to. I don't know. If there's a public domain version of it, I will be happy to include it.
But the first line is 1 ounce of liquor.
Yes.
The second line is 5 ounces of wine. And then the third line is 12 ounces of beer.
Interesting. So, had no
and
idea.
You were just putting Natty Light in them. You had no idea.
Well, the more you know.
Red Solo Cups. And you see, dear listeners, you have learned a lot this show.
Yes, it's been a very educational
Not
show.
Not much to talk about with gaming, but you learned a lot this show. But thank you for tuning in. And like I said, Laura, thank you for joining us after your long holiday. I know it was tough getting back up to speed.
Happy to be here.
At least you didn't make an idiot out of yourself and show up for work on a national holiday like I almost did.
Well, at least you had a good day. Sounds like you played Witcher.
Yeah,
most
we played
of the
Witcher.
Day.
Jeff and I went and had a nice, delightful lunch. Mm-hmm. Right, didn't we, Jeffrey?
We did. Now I just looked on Snopes, and those lines apparently mean nothing.
Aww.
So forget I said anything.
Oh, no.
This is how rumors start. Man, well, you know, I'm gonna have to
go see if the 12 elves are actually real.
Snope those guys and see
no,
if they're real.
They're real.
Okay, all right.
I've seen them.
Okay,
I've seen window peeper.
Yes. By the way, what you just witnessed here is something we highly recommend you do in your life. Which is when you hear something, go double check it. Just
fact
don't
check.
Take news for face value.
Yeah,
Jeffrey thought he had something and he went and checked it.
Yeah.
Jeff, you're going to get an A+ and a gold star today.
Of course, for all the people that shut the show off after I said
fair point.
No one ever reads the retraction.
There'll be a half of something in your extra something in your pay bucket this week. So, all right, gang, we'll talk to you guys next time. Have a great week and make sure you follow us on Twitter. You can find me at Major Nelson. You can find Jeffrey at Jeff Rubenstein.
Rubenstein. Thank you.
Laura, they can find the lovely Laura Lollipop at?
At Laura Lollipop.
That's exactly where it is.
Mm-hmm.
So,
exactly.
And if you get confused at all, just find me and Drew. They are two-thirds of the people that I follow.
Yeah.
I think two-thirds of the people that I follow are in
this
room.
Thanks for following me, Larry.
So I need to ask, so thank you. Of course, Laura, you're part of the show. Now, it's funny because I follow a few people and I'm going to need to ask you, dear listeners, what should I do here? Because I followed E because we worked together and he was on the show, but he's no longer on the show and I'm still following him. So what do I do? Awkward moment.
If you unfollow him, that will be a Reddit thread.
So yeah. It'll be a news headline.
Yeah, it'll be right under Nicki Minaj and Meek Mill breakup.
All right, so we'll figure that one out. Let me know what you guys think, and we'll talk to you guys next time. Bye bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Bye bye. Happy New Year.